Hello again, everyone. Marcus here. I review stuff today. I'm reviewing the song Heaven Coming Down by the Tea Party. As always, the song comes to you as a request from one of my viewers. So if you would like to have your song reviewed, just do what they did. Leave it in the comments and I'll be sure to add it to my list. And hey, you know, while you're hanging out, you might as well like the video, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications. Hey, you can even check the description to follow me on Twitch, Twitter, or TikTok. With that said, I don't think I've ever listened to anything from the Tea Party. I don't think I have, at least. So going in pretty fresh, you know, clean set of ears here, and just hoping for a good song. So with that, let's jump right in. Again, this is Heaven Coming Down by the Tea Party. Let's do it. Honestly, it was a pretty good song. I liked it. Really enjoyed when that drum beat really kicked in. Really enjoyed the drum beat throughout the song. I thought the drumming was, to me, one of the stronger parts of it. I thought the guitar work was good. Overall, just kind of a good song. You know, if I had some complaints, maybe a little bit kind of reminiscent of like early 2000s rock, maybe. That's not that much of a criticism, more so that it sounded familiar, sounded like something I've heard before. But I mean, overall, a pretty good song. So let's break it down piece by piece, like we always do, of course, starting with those lyrics. All right, so let's see. With nothing to do, you'd waste away, obscured in exile. They've witnessed the times you've gone astray, and whose fault now you're thinking. With nothing to do, you'd waste away. So basically just like, hey, if you didn't have shit to do, left to your own devices, you would just, you know, wouldn't be much left of you. There's nothing to prove, a snapshot from the crowd to the shore, baby. Now, there's nothing to prove, a snapshot from the crowd to the shore. I have no idea what that means. And it feels now like just like heaven's coming down. So strange are the ways, they all have changed. Still life, it stayed the same. A break from the past could make it last, oh, maybe just a little longer. So people may be changing, even though, you know, life is the same for most people, right? Like, life is life, but the people themselves kind of change throughout their life journey. Now there's nothing to prove, snapshot from the crowd to the shore. So maybe I think what they're saying here is like, maybe as a person, you have nothing to prove, right? Like your life is like picking out a snapshot from the crowd. Like the crowd could be huge, right? And you are just one small part of it. Same thing, like, and that's why they, I think, also compare it to the shore, kind of alluding to the ocean at large, right? Like compared to the ocean, we're like nothing. Compared to the universe, we're nothing. I think that's kind of what he's saying here. That's what I'm getting from it. And it feels now just like heaven's coming down, your soul shakes free, and its conscience hits the ground. You surrender love under will. Love under will. Love under will. From an important phrase in the Lima, love is the law, love under will. Jeff Martin is an avowed devotee of the works of occultist Aleister Crowley and has stated that the Book of the Law, in particular, from which the phrase comes, is very important to him. Interesting. I would not have known that without clicking on that little thing there. You surrender love under will. Rest assured, baby, you are adored. And it feels now just like heaven's coming down. Your soul shakes free and its conscience hits the ground. These signs, this fate, takes a path you didn't choose. Stay strong, keep faith. There is a change that's coming, though. That's coming through, sorry. And so I wonder, like, you know, sometimes in life things happen to you, right? Path you didn't choose, but you just kind of stay strong, keep the faith, and you'll be all right. I think that's what he's saying here. Feels like heaven's coming down. And, you know, it feels like kind of the end of the world, right? Like, heaven is, I guess, supposed to be like the most pure thing or whatever, right? The most pure place. And even if even that is crumbling, you know, it's just so like life is hard, you know? So that's kind of what he's getting at with that imagery. Hold on, my love. Feels like heaven's coming down. Hold on, my love. Feels like heaven's coming down. Yeah. You know, lyrically, I think there's definitely some allusions and innuendo here that, oh, this actually came out in 1999. I guess. I thought, that makes more sense now, actually. It came out in 99 because I was just thinking that it was newer because I think it was only uploaded to YouTube, like, what, 7 years ago, looks like? Okay, so this is actually a bit of an older song, which makes sense because it sounds to me like a lot of the rock of its time. But yeah, no, I thought lyrically it was okay. I mean, a lot of allusions and references that maybe are going over my head. And I think I kind of have a reading on it, but I'm not 100% sure. But it didn't really do much for me lyrically, so for that, go neutral. I mean, the writing wasn't bad by any means. Definitely can't give it a thumb down, but it didn't really inspire or invoke anything in me that I was just like, yeah, lyrics, yeah, whatever. So I'll stay neutral on that one. As far as the instrumentation goes, though, I really did enjoy kind of the guitar work throughout. I thought that was pretty good. The vocals, I thought his voice was pretty nice. Again, maybe a little bit generic. Kind of very similar to the rock of its time. Liked the little bit of raspiness, kind of the edge he gave us near the end. But I think to me the highlight of the song was the drumming, to be honest. When that drum beat first kicks in, I'm like, okay, this is groovy, this is cool. And then you really, really get some cool drum fills throughout the song itself. And so, yeah, I mean, I kind of like that about it. Overall, I mean, not a bad song. Definitely could see myself listening to it again. So for that, I'll give it a thumb up instrumentally and vocally. And like I just said, Could see myself listening to it again. I'll probably put it on the playlist. I think it might benefit from a second listen, if I'm being honest. With that said, to me, it did come off as maybe a little bit cheesy, just the way it was sung. And so for that, I don't know how much I'm going to come back to it, but it will at least kind of sit in the playlist for a little bit. So for that, I'll give it a thumb up for replay value. Overall, again, not a bad song. Maybe just a little bit different than what I normally like. And again, maybe I need to hear a little bit more from this band to really get a sense of their style. But, you know, overall, not a bad request. So thank you so much for the person who requested this one. As always, if you want that to be you, you want your song reviewed, just do what they did. Leave it in the comments, and I'll be sure to add it to my list. And again, so much other stuff you can do to help out the channel. Like, subscribe, turn on notifications, and of course, follow me on TikTok, Twitter, Twitch, all the tea places by checking the description. And as always, I shan't forget, if you enjoyed the music, go support the artists. The whole reason I'm here. You know, without the artists, there wouldn't be my channel when you think about it. So go support the artists. Go listen to their music wherever you can. All right, guys, that's going to be it for me. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye for now.